to the hill where they were hanged, there was just kind of a rocky slope. And after their hanging, the bodies would simply be cast into the rocks. Though we know from some of the diaries that families would sometimes that night, in the dark of night, sneak up to the hill and bear the bodies away and bury them in secret. We don't know if that was the case for Mary Esty, whose sister, by the way, was also among the executed witches. So here she is. Thus is she ferried over the River Jordan at last in the mouths of ants, for her bones are flaking. For the hide beetles have unstrung her thews and sinews, for her flesh has been rendered to grave wax by the acids of her own decay, and cheese moths and scuttle flies dabble their tongues in her drippings. For she has become gravid with maggots, whose churning rocks her corpse from side to side. For her specter appears again to Mary Herrick, crying, "Vengeance, vengeance." For her skin blisters and slips from her limbs, for fluid seeps from her mouth and her eyes, for her eyes and her tongue protrude, and her torso bloats and splits open from death's exhalations. For her skin marbles black and green as bacilli swarm along her veins. For the lining of her veins congeals and the trapped blood darkens to purple. For a paste of flies have found her in minutes. They will attend upon her, being faithful unto death. For she is flung with the others into crevices among the rocks. For 8 firebrands of hell hang from the tree. For her lungs are 2 wasps' nests. Their fiery wasps boil in her chest, for she chokes in the noose. For through the muslin hood, the world is a patchwork of shadows and brightness. For she has tendered her family her farewells and prayed with them. For though the cart cried out and balked under its load, they are brought to the hilltop. For from her jail cell, her specter appears to Mary Herrick, saying, "On the morrow, I go upon the ladder to be hanged for a witch, though I am innocent."